In this green one, you can see pepper already started growing. The tiny peppers are growing here. But this is flower stage. Flowers are so tiny. You know, who is doing pollination?
The birds and the animals.
Birds can't do this pollination.
The wind will do it.
Ant, wind, then who else?
Monkeys.
Oh, small, right?
The Agarwal Back Coorg is undoubtedly one of the best resorts in India. It has nearly perfect reviews on almost every single website it is listed on. My wife Kamakshi and I visited the property in June and we were completely blown away. But before I show you everything in exquisite detail, let me quickly give you a glimpse of some of the amazingness you can expect. There are only 63 villas in a 300-acre coffee plantation which is absolutely beautiful, filled with all kinds of flora and fauna you can think of. The villas are split across four different categories. The smallest villa is about 1600 square feet, which is already quite huge by most resort standards. But the biggest one and the one in which my wife and I stayed was almost 4500 square feet, which is like so much space that most of the time you don't really know what to do. And each villa comes with its own private pool, which just elevates the package to a whole new level. Depending on which one you choose, it can cost you anywhere between 18,000 to 32,000 per villa per night. So I guess that's a little bit expensive. But is it worth it? We'll find out. The hospitality is simply out of this world and has to be experienced to be believed. In fact, during our stay there, most of the time the staff at the Agarwal Back Coorg went something like this. And even if you made out of the blue requests, they went something like, yes, the hospitality is that good. And coming to the food, you know, what do you expect?
Bhai. Maza aaya.
The food is really authentic, amazing, and it will leave you wanting for more every single time. In addition, there are so many things you can do within the property itself that you hardly need to leave the property, whether it be bird watching, cycling, nature trails, walking, jeep trail, whatever it is, Ayurvedic treatment, you name it. They have everything. They have their own paddy fields, they have their own artificial lake, they have their own plantation. So, you know, the world is your oyster when you're there, and it's simply one of the best properties to be in, to relax, to unwind, and to simply chill with your loved ones. So without any further ado, let's jump right into the review. About a 5-hour drive from Bangalore, and the roads keep getting narrower and the views more beautiful the closer you get to the property. And if you love driving, you'll absolutely love the drive.
Rishav Agarwal.
The property is so magical that the moment you enter it, you immediately feel a change within yourself. In fact, I got so carried away that I forgot to keep shooting and I had to come back sometime later to shoot it again, but by then it had started raining. Anyways, this is the entrance to the reception where you get your welcome drink. I've shamelessly used a clip from Agarwal Back's official channel to show you what it looked like.
Namaskar.
As you can see, every single thing is extremely well done and is as per Kodagu architecture. The paintings on the wall are of the Ramapuram family, who are the big daddies of Agarwal Back and own thousands of acres of coffee estates around.
A lot of receptions when you enter, you feel very overwhelmed. They are so huge. This feels much more like a very, very welcoming, very inviting space. And the lighting is also very gentle, very beautiful. These are the buggies that normally whisk you around the property, and they are at your beck and call whenever you want them. Just give a call to a number.
Once you're done with your check-in, your luggage is loaded on the buggy and off you go to your villa. So, Shilpa, this is Shilpa. She was our go-to person throughout our stay and took extremely good care of us. If we ever requested her something, for example, Shilpa, can you please book us a nice dinner for today? Before we knew it, she came back with...
Tonight dinner I have booked in a peppercorn restaurant, right?
Perfect.
So you can go to the peppercorn.
Thank you. And obviously the dinner was free since we were booked under the full board option. Here's a pro tip. Whenever you have a full board option available at a resort in a remote location like this, take it immediately. It's usually cheaper and you don't need to do mental maths with the menu prices every time you want to eat at the restaurants. And before we knew it, we reached our villa.
Krishna ke bhi roop
that we have that out of the way, let me take you through a proper review of the villa. This is the path that actually leads on to the villa. The series of villas on this side of the property are the heritage pool villas. They are facing the lake. As you can see, it's a very, very beautiful villa. The architecture is very similar or very typical of Kodava architecture, which was the traditional architecture of Kodagu people. The two pillars that you see in the front is a very typical entrance. The very tasteful door that's made of solid wood. And let me show you what's inside. The moment you enter the villa, you are first greeted by a central courtyard or an angan, which is still very common throughout homes in India. To the left of the courtyard, you have a huge drawing slash dining slash living area that contains ample sitting space, a TV, an electric kettle, and plenty of fruits that are refilled twice every day by the housekeeping. By the way, the room cleaning staff come not just once, but twice every day to make sure everything is tip-top. This is what the housekeeping got me when I asked them for a bottle of Coke. By the way, you're allowed to bring your own booze to the property as long as you consume it within the villa. And you should definitely think of getting it because A, the bar was closed when we visited and is probably still closed. And B, it's much cheaper and you get exactly what you want. The Wi-Fi was good enough for Zoom calls and should serve all of your work from home needs. They've also added a dressing table here in case you're too tired appreciating everything around you and want to do a little self-appreciation. The bedroom, which is to the right of the courtyard, has a rustic vibe and is quite cozy. The bed is king-sized and will probably remind you of your grandparents' old beds with the four posts around it for a mosquito net or a macheri as we call it in Hindi.
The mattress was honestly a bit too soft for me and unfortunately I couldn't change it because they didn't have the option. If they do provide harder mattresses, it might help some of the IT folks with back pain coming in from Bangalore.
Beside the bed, you have another dressing table for some more self-admiration. Opposite the bed, you have a cabinet, a luggage stand and the bathroom. The cabinet has a safe, additional pillows, towels, bathrobes and complimentary slippers. The bathroom, although really beautiful, could have definitely been bigger, at least around the bathtub, which honestly feels a bit neglected to the side. The toiletries smelled amazing and are neatly arranged on the side table. They have a special box for toilet papers which I found quite cute and the towels are kept on the rack above. But the best part about the bathroom is this opening that lets nature in and makes it so much more beautiful. In case it's raining outside, which it most certainly will, you can have a most surreal hot shower experience with the rain falling right in front of you. What's even better is that this gate opens out directly to your private pool and you don't have to worry about getting dirt and water all over your villa.
And that brings me to the most amazing part of the villa, the private pool.
Pool is absolutely huge. In fact, many residential society pools are smaller than this. It is also completely temperature controlled and the water here is so clean that you can see a person swim towards you from the other end of the pool.
The temperature control is without a doubt the most critical part of the pool because it keeps the water at a very pleasant 27 degrees all the time, which is perfect to enjoy in. Without that, although you would have a pool, but you would not really use it because it gets very cold when it rains in Coorg. And cold water is not good at all. Remember what happened to Jack? Therefore, the temperature control in my opinion is a must-have and although all 63 villas offer you a private pool, only two room categories, the heritage pool villa and the lily pool villa, offer temperature control.
The water here in your private pool is very, very gentle on your skin. There's no itching, there's no rashes.
Absolutely nothing, even after spending hours in the water. I cannot even begin to describe how amazing it felt to be immersed in this kind of water without a care in the world. What really takes it to the next level is that this pool also has a jacuzzi-like bubble area which provides a very relaxing massage. After about 15 minutes of struggle, I finally discovered the exact spot that made me very happy.
This is a very nice spot for a jacuzzi. Now, one of the biggest concerns with having your own pools, especially for couples, is that of privacy. But that's where Evolveback shines, as all of its villas have close to 100% privacy.
Ours was a heritage pool villa with a lake view, which compared to other villas gave us less privacy, but we still chose it because we absolutely loved its location. Despite that, we felt completely shielded anytime we were inside the pool. It was only when we were out of the pool walking in the backyard that we felt some loss of privacy. For 100% privacy, you should choose the plantation view villas, where instead of these bushes to the front, you have dense plantation trees that grow all the way up to the top. It looks something like this. And combined with these mud walls to your left and right,
and the villa to your back, you can relax without any disturbance or worry.
However, you will have surprise checks by these guys who come to collect their dues.
The backyard also has tons of space to laze around. There are a pair of recliners in front of both bedroom and the living room, which is a perfect setup for book lovers like myself. Just by the poolside, you have these extremely comfortable sun loungers, and in case you want to enjoy the rain while sipping hot coffee, it couldn't get any better than this. Needless to say, this backyard pool area was where we spent most of our time in the resort. We would often sit outside admiring the play of nature, wondering how amazing it would be to come back here sometime. Sometimes the peace was so overpowering that it made me do random things like this. And in the evenings, the animals put up such a spectacular orchestra that you had to listen in amazement.
This place is absolutely magical.
But only when it starts raining can you truly appreciate the beauty of Coorg. So I'll shut up for a while and let you enjoy the rain. Honestly, it feels much better with a mystical piano background, so let me add one for you.
Whenever we were not chilling in the villas, we were eating in one of the restaurants.
The first and the main restaurant is the granary that serves you everything, breakfast, lunch and dinner. And the minute you enter the restaurant, the sights and sounds and smells of this beautiful live kitchen to the right immediately kickstarts a massive fire in your belly. You are then greeted and taken to a seat of your choosing. We usually chose a seat right next to the window because of the fantastic paddy field and plantation views. You can also see the common swimming pool outside, but of course it was closed due to COVID. You only need to wait for a couple of minutes before the service staff start attending to your table, and I must add that they were quite prompt with all our requests. Because of COVID precautions, they didn't have an open buffet, but instead the staff brought us whatever we wanted from the menu. The breakfast is quite amazing, especially the dosas, which I probably enjoyed more than I should have. And if you're a coffee lover like Kamakshi, prepare to be blown away. The coffee beans used are from their own plantation, and the coffee is served in a traditional brass cup.
Are you sure itna sugar tumhe nahi sahi kamakshi?
She's blissed out.
You should definitely come here during off hours if you want to enjoy the beauty of this place, because it gets quite crowded during meal times. In the spirit of ecotourism, which Evolve Back stands for, they've also employed a group of sparrows to help with the cleaning. And I must say that the sparrows seemed quite serious about their work given the job market right now. The second restaurant is the Peppercorn, and it's actually the most beautifully located restaurant of the property, just overlooking the lake. The restaurant's deck has beautiful views of the lake, and if things permit, you can also dine on this deck. But mostly the food is served there, which is the main part of the restaurant. While we were staying, only dinner was being served here because of low occupancy, and it actually turned out for the best because dinners here are simply unbelievable. The restaurant only uses candles during dinner time, no electric lights, and just for a moment, try to imagine yourself sitting here at night, surrounded by candlelight and the reflection of the villas and lamps on the lake in front of you. It's truly magical. The restaurant's speciality is Mughlai and North Indian dishes, and believe me when I say, everything was finger-licking good. The kebabs tasted great, and the tandoori chicken did not disappoint at all. Our absolute favorites were the dal makhani, which is cooked overnight and tasted heavenly. The staff insisted we order the sizzler, and we were so glad they did. It turned out to be so good that we ended up ordering it again the next day. And what's a good dinner that doesn't end with a hot chocolate fudge that sizzled more than a sizzler? By the time we were done with our dinner, all that was left to do was to wonder if it could get any better.
So this is the third restaurant that they have. It's called the Plantain Leaf. Unfortunately, it was closed when we were here. But it serves you breakfast, lunch and dinner, just like the granary. And they say it's just as good. So you will have to find that out yourself.
On one particular day, when we were feeling extra lazy, we requested the team if they could send lunch to our room. And here's what we got.
This is skewered vegetables with rice and mashed potatoes. This is roast chicken. This is the dessert.
apple pie. I think there's akki roti in this. There's some kind of a roti in this. This is mutton sukka. This is another curry. This is the bamboo curry, which is a specialty of Evolve Back. This is steamed rice. This is peeli dal. This is the aloo ki sabzi. The spaghetti arrabbiata.
I have to say it was quite good. Mm-hmm. There's also a fourth restaurant which honeymooners and couples who believe in maximum romance will definitely love. It's a raised deck restaurant in the middle of nowhere, and it has a seating capacity for only one couple at a time. Obviously, there's an extra charge associated to it. We didn't try it, but you should, because it looks like a very unique experience. By the way, Coorg is famous for its non-veg preparations, and the restaurants do it really well here. So if you have a no non-veg kind of thing going on, you can drop it for a couple of days. After eating all that amazing food and chilling in the villa, you might want to burn off a few calories here and there. They have tons of activities in the resort for almost each age group.
In addition to bird watching, cycling and coracle rides on the Cauvery River, you can go to the compound where the library, gift shop and activity room with games like TT, Carom and chess are located. The library has one of the best views that you can expect in a library. However, it was quite lacking in books. In case you're a shopaholic or just want to buy Evolve Back's coffee or fragrances for your family and friends, then the gift shop has you covered. Just beside the gift shop, you'll find a daily schedule of activities that you can engage in. In case you want to learn more about coffee, there's a dedicated space where they show you the entire process from seed to finish. And after drinking some good coffee, you can bask in the shade of a tree that was planted by none other than Thalaiwa.
We are actually standing on hallowed grounds, and the reason for that is this. I can feel his aura still pervading the space.
For nature and outdoor lovers, the list is simply endless. Their nursery and nature shop are a paradise for gardening lovers. You can go on long walks on one of their many, many well-maintained trails that have a wide variety of trees and plants. One of the paths even has a lake on one side and a paddy field on the other, and very few properties in the world can claim to have that. Our walks were often interrupted by sounds of these buggies, and they were a welcome sight whenever we were tired.
So we're currently heading to our room, and riding these buggies are actually one of the most fun things to do. They're completely eco-friendly. I hope their electricity is coming from a solar power plant. I think it is coming from one of their windmills that they own, so it's all renewable energy.
But the one experience that I really recommend, despite the extra cost, is the plantation jeep trail.
It's a 2 to 3 hour long experience where you indulge in a most scenic jeep ride. Enjoy 360 degree views of the coffee estate, which is one of the oldest in Coorg, and learn interesting tidbits like
something like a deep, you know. This is actually called elephant proof trench. If the trench is not there, directly elephants they come to our plantation.
Okay.
Especially this season they are coming because jackfruit season. They can smell jackfruits from kilometers distance. This is second hottest chill in India.
Monkeys.
This is happening with a rain. Single drop water is enough to pollinate this catkin.
Oh, wow.
You know, wherever rainfall is good, there you will see pepper plantations. Kerala, best example. That is why our coffee we are using 80 Arabica, 20 Robusta. Coffee bean.
Toward the end of this experience, they gave us a really nice surprise, which made us go,
wow, Modi ji, wow.
But I won't reveal it here because I don't want to spoil the surprise of others, and you can enjoy it for yourself.
You can also spend time on the lakeside deck pretending to feed the fishes when all you really want to do is see them fight.
Lord of the Rings has just started over here.
Their bar, which is aptly named the Hunter's Lodge, and the Ayurvedic Spa were unfortunately closed. So definitely get your own drinks and some Walini. With Evolve Back's philosophy of sustainable tourism, they have their own water recycling plant, use their own RO systems for drinking water in the rooms, and generally refrain from using plastics wherever possible. The property has to be one of the most well-designed and well-maintained properties in India. You love walking around the property despite the fact that it's located in a hilly region, because it's landscaped in such a way that there are no steep inclines anywhere. And unlike a lot of other big properties where the layouts are so complex that even after staying for 4 or 5 days you keep getting lost all the time, the layout here is so simple that you can understand it in just 5 seconds.
Let me prove it to you. Okay, start the timer. Draw a twisted number 9 like so. That's the main artery of the resort around which the entire resort is structured. Now add some hair-like things to this number 9. These are the sub-arteries or sub-paths that connect to the main artery. Here's your reception. Here's the lake. Here are the paddy fields and the organic farm along with the nursery. The Lakeview Heritage Villas are over here. And we are also somewhere here. This is where your other villas and buildings are located.
Here are your restaurants.
And this entire 35-acre resort compound is about 10% of the whole estate. Towards the left here, you have the remaining 265 acres that form the remaining part of the estate. And here's a comparison with the actual resort map. And did I say 5 seconds? I actually meant 25 seconds.
And despite being in one of the wettest regions in the world, there was absolutely zero seepage in any of the walls. In fact, the woodwork too was looking brand new. And of course, the private pool and the water in it was maintained beyond expectation. Here is a video from Taj Bakal's private pool, which is one of Taj's flagship properties in Kerala, with almost equivalent rates. Now, I'm not saying that Taj does a bad job at it. In fact, many of Taj's properties have pools which have exceptionally good water. All I'm saying is that it gets difficult even for brands like Taj to maintain water quality at this level. And they pamper you with so much attention right from the time you check in that it becomes extremely hard for you to check out.
The last ride. Please, this bug.
Maybe like the ride to remember.
I need to sanitize my hands.
Now, Evolve Bike is definitely not exuberant or lavish in the modern sense. For example, you won't find international cuisines such as Thai or Japanese being served here. And you can stay at much more opulent looking properties in the cities for almost one third the price. But where Evolve Bike's strength truly lies is in conveying the culture and richness of its land with exceptional authenticity. Now, Coorg is really known for its coffee plantations, its world-class hospitality, its architecture that blends with nature, and its food. And Evolve Bike delivers on all of that better than anybody else. And for that reason, I would say it's well worth the price that they're charging you. If you're a couple, a honeymooner, or just want to disconnect from your private life and enjoy a retreat with your family and friends, definitely try coming here and you'll not regret it. Any time in the year is good enough because the weather is good throughout. But July to September, when it's rainy in Coorg, is when nature really turns up the magic. Growing up, Malgudi Days used to be one of my favorite shows because of how simple that world seemed. And there was such joy around in the atmosphere, the village setting. And I always imagined what it would be like to ever live in a place like this. Somehow, Evolve Bike allowed me a taste of that childhood fantasy and transported me back in time. And for that, I am extremely grateful to that team. I hope you like the video and thank you so much for watching it till here. I'm Rishav Agarwal and I love making such videos around my experiences, my experiments with as much detail, humor and accuracy as possible. So do let me know what your thoughts are. Hopefully you like more things in the video than you didn't like. And we'll meet again in my next video. And until then, agar aapko video achha laga,
to aise thoda maar dijiye haath aap. Thoda sa maar dijiye. Agar achhi lagi, maar dijiye.